Hallelujah. God is just so amazing. And you know, all throughout, even in my preparation, you know, I had one thing, but then 2 days ago, God said, no one, that's not quite it. I need for the atmosphere here. It is good. It is really good. But this is a moment where I need the atmosphere to go to an even deeper and higher level in me. So I want them to hear that your everything must belong to me.
Yes, yes.
My everything belongs to you, and my answer is simply this, a yes. A wholeheartedly yes, a completely surrendered, a completely yielded yes to everything that he says to do. Lord, I will do it. Whatever he says to say, God, I will say. I won't complain, I won't hesitate, but God, I will go wherever you tell me to go. So we're going to go to Isaiah chapter 6, and we're going to start in verse 1, and if you could stand, hallelujah. And this is a little lengthy reading, but I promise you it is worth it. Isaiah chapter 6, we're going to start in verse 1 and go all the way to verse 8. Hallelujah. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lifted up. And the train of his robe filled the temple. And above it stood seraphim. Each one had 6 wings. With 2 worthy enough pleasing to God. Amen. It was the golden altar speaks to us of the worship of Jesus Christ and God's people through him as our high priest. It was only on the basis of his one sacrifice on the altar of the cross that worship is made possible. These coals, these same coals which lit the incense, was carried from the altar of sacrifice to the altar of incense. And then the angel took the coal from the altar. He touched his lips only to let him know, my son,
yes,
you are cleansed. You your own. 1 Corinthians 6:19 through 20. He says, don't you realize that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who lives in you and was given to you by God? You don't belong to yourself. For God bought you with a high price. So you must honor God with your very being. It's in Him that I live, I move, and I have my being. Everything in me, God, it belongs to you. My worship belongs to you. My praise belongs to you. My prayer belongs to you. My conversation belongs to you. My heart belongs to you. My emotions belong to you. Everything that I have, God, it belongs to you. But even in those moments where we forget, and sometimes we mess up the big trip. And God sees it.
Yes.
And He knows it.
Yes, He does.
But then that's when God, He steps in as the potter.
Mm. Yes.
In Jeremiah 18, 1 through 6.
Yes.
This is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. God told Jeremiah, I want you to go down to the potter's house. And I'm going to give you a message there. So when he went down to the potter's house and he saw the potter working the clay, but this piece of clay, it wasn't quite right. So the potter formed it in another pot. He mashed it up. And then he reshaped it. And he remolded it. Reformed it in another pot. And then he asked, the Lord asked Jeremiah, can I not do with you as this potter does? To manifest, in order for the new one. moving according to your will, your plan, and your purpose of being totally and completely usable for you. I don't mind, Lord, whatever you need to do within me, God, you do it. Here I am. Here I am. As a worshiper, your answer must be yes, here I am.
Yes, yes.
As the dancer, God, here I am. As the singers, Lord, here I am. As the musicians, Lord, here I am. Because when you truly get to that place of here I am, God can then begin to release a new sound. He can then begin to release a new revelation and illumination of the word. Now the word of God never changes. The word of God is the same today, yesterday, and forever. But God can give you a different revelation. Based on what he desires and needs for you to go. And during this time and season, he says, I'm looking for those that will come truly into the secret place.
Yeah.
So that I can truly and once and for all remove the scales from the eyes so that they can see clearly. So that their ears can be open. Unlock the deaf ears, Father. I need their ears to be open so that they can hear strategies, directions, territory that they're supposed to overtake.
Yes.
It's one thing to worship and to minister in the four walls of the church, but God said, I want you to go into the four corners of the earth. Yeah. Yeah. I can't go into the four corners of the earth with blinding eyes and blocked ears. So I have to be able to hear God wherever you send me, I'll go. Even if they don't want to hear it, you're allowing your mouthpiece in the earth.
Ministry.
I served in the community. And I thought I was Lord, forgive me. Wash me totally in happiness. Make me over, God. Make me a new God. Because I don't want to miss anything while I'm here. I want to truly live a life that's completely and totally poured out before the Father. When I stand before Him, I want to stand before Him empty. Nothing left. My everything belongs to you.
Yes.
And then he can begin to trust you.
Yes.
With the greater.
Yes.
Because after you have emptied yourself out, now he can begin to pour more into you. And there's a greater capacity for you to hold it.
Yes.
Too much is given, much is required. There's a greater capacity that you now have to hold the anointing that He wants to bestow upon you. There's a greater capacity that you now have of empowerment from the Holy Spirit that will cause you to move and watch miracles.
And I'll go. I pray that you all have been blessed. Amen.